They make your butt look big.
They do?
I'm kidding.
Oh my God, they do. They make my butt look big.
Trust me, honey. Trust me, your butt looked just as big before you put them on. There's probably a better way to say that.
Yeah, I think so, but don't bother trying to find it. I'm just gonna go up and look in a fully mirror.
You know, if you had different glasses, you wouldn't have to cover that thing.
Hello to you too, Jeff.
Hey, Tim.
Where's your date?
Right here.
Woo-hee, and what a looker.
Well, my date stood me up, so I figured I'd treat my little brother. Yeah. Said if I'm good, he'd buy me a snow cone.
I'd like to talk to Jeff in private. Go stick my finger in your back seat.
You make it sound so dirty. So what's up?
Well, it's really none of my business, but how are you affording real expensive hockey tickets?
Well, I'm just celebrating, you know, open up a new business.
You opened up a new business?
Yeah, I had this brainstorm for a mailbox and shipping store.
There's a problem, though, isn't there?
What?
You're broke.
Not anymore, Timmy. Got a very generous loan.
I would think it'd be tough to get a bank loan when your last business went belly up.
Yeah, well, you know, I got a private backer. And there's the money that I owe you. I'm sorry it took so long to get it back.
Well, a private backer?
Yeah, private.
Someone gave you cash for a private backer?
Yeah.
Who's a private backer?
Oh, I thought I mentioned it. Mom? Bye.
Well, I figured out how come Jeff can afford expensive hockey tickets, pay off his loan in cash, and open a new business.
What did he do, rob a bank?
Yeah, the bank of Mom. He got her to crack open her nest egg so he can open a mailbox and shipping business.
Oh, my God. And with Jeff's luck, he'll turn it into another one of those, K-mutts.
I'm going to go over to her house after the hockey game, and I'm going to tell Mr. Chrome Dome a little bit about fiscal responsibility. I got to yell at the guy. I got to tell him, little
Tim,
brother, not...
Tim, you can talk to him until you're blue in the face. It's not going to do any good.
Well, what am I supposed to do about it?
Maybe I should go over there and beat him up with my big butt.
Full house, queen's high.
Oh, no.
Who is it?
The FBI, ma'am. I'm here for your strip search.
It's all right. It's only Tim.
I love your son in that show. They should just get rid of the obnoxious one that's always breaking things.
I think you're a little mixed up.
Hey, Mom. Oh, hi.
Hi.
This broke outside. It wasn't me, I swear. Give me a screwdriver, I'll go put it back on.
Never mind. Say hello to Gwen, Bertha, Alice, and Lois.
Oh, hello, Tim.
Hi, ladies.
Oh, so you finally got a toupee.
No. It's my older brother, Jeff. This isn't a toupee.
Whatever you say.
So, speaking of Jeff, is he here? I want to talk to him.
He'll be back any second.
Say, while you're waiting, would you like to play a little poker?
I couldn't take your money, ladies.
Suddenly, I am tired.
It's funny how fatigue sets in after winning all my money.
Hey, Tim, ladies.
Lucille, walk me home, will you? All this money that I won from Tim is putting a lot of weight on my bad hip.
Let me say double nothing. Let's get oiled up and I'll wrestle you for it.
I'd crush you like a grape.
Hey, you missed one heck of a game, bud.
Did I?
Yeah, and I'd like to hang on to your finger. I got tickets for next week's game.
Jeff, we heard about your new business. Sounds wonderful.
Maybe you should just give up your little TV skits and follow in your brother's footsteps.
I would, but I'd like to leave my mom some money to retire on.
Hey, what's that supposed to mean?
Why are you borrowing money from Mom to start another fly-by-night business? You had to take money from her to pay me off for the last loan.
First of all, this is between Mom and me, okay? And second of all, she gave me the money because she thinks my fly-by-night business is a good idea.
Oh, like Poodle Town?
Auto Pet. And look, I don't have to be talked to this way, okay? I'm your older brother, not a child. I'm going to my room.
Hey, Wilson.
Hi-ho, Tim.
So your light was on. What are you doing to the Studebaker?
Oh, nothing very interesting. Just draining my radiator.
Well, I'd rather watch that than watch my brother drain my mother.
Who wouldn't?
Jeff got my mom to give him a big loan to start a new business.
A new business? Whatever happened to Long John Schnauzers?
Well, it folded. Now he's on to his next failure.
Oh, yes, so I see. So you're worried about your mom losing her money.
Yeah. I talked to Jeff about it. He just said it's none of my business.
Well, it's true that that loan had nothing to do with you, but considering Jeff's track record, the concerns you have for your mother are totally understandable.
Yeah, so I'm caught between a rock and a bald guy.
You know, Tim, I can't find the drain plug in this thing. Can you give me a hand?
It's an old Studebaker. It's over here on the left side. Mm. Get a lantern?
Yep, right here.
So you came off a ship. Would you get it off the Titanic?
Yes. Well, have you considered talking to your mom?
I can't talk to my mom about this.
Why not?
What, tell her that I think that her oldest son, my brother, is a loser?
Well, Tim, if that is the case, it'll hurt her feelings, but isn't that better than seeing her savings wiped out?
So what are you saying I should do? Just lay it out, put everything on the table?
Well, I'm reminded of the famous words, when in doubt, tell the truth. Samuel Langhorne Clemens.
The big cartoon rooster? What I say, boy.
No. See, Samuel Clemens is the real name of Mark Twain, one of America's greatest thinkers.
Well, that big chicken's pretty smart. Gave that dog a run for his money. I say, boy, that dog is dumber than a sack of wet beans. Is Jeff home?
No, he's out looking for some packing materials for his new store.
Well, that's what I want to talk about. I don't think you should loan him the money.
You don't?
I think he's taking advantage of you, Mom.
Oh, I can look after myself, Tim.
You gotta save some money for a rainy day. I mean, you never know when you're gonna blow out a hip.
Look, I've invested pretty well over the years, and I can afford to take a risk if I really believe in it, like Jeff's mailbox business.
I can see it now. He can have his grand opening sale and going on a business sale on one day.
Tim, Jeff has really done his homework this time. These places do very well, and he's found a very good location.
Oh, so that's why when he hits you up for money, you just fork it over to him?
He didn't hit me up for the money. I had to talk him into taking it.
Wait a minute. You talked him into this? You believe in this that much? Well, why did he tell me this?
Well, I'm sure he was embarrassed. Your approval means a lot to him, Tim.
Since when did he care what I think?
You guys give each other a hard time, but deep down, oh, Jeff truly admires you.
Oh, I don't think so.
Honey, you've got everything in the world that he'd like to have. You've got a successful career. You've got a great family.
Hair.
Yeah, that too. I'd love to see Jeff get some of that good stuff. That's why I gave him the money. I'd do the same for you, honey.
Boy, Mom, you cannot believe all the shipping material that's out there these days. Oh, packing peanuts, foam, popcorn. Makes me thirsty for a scotch tape and soda. How are you? What, are you here to convince Mom that I'm a bad risk?
No, Jeff, I just came over to talk.
Oh, this is good. Okay, I just think I'll go out and pop some bubbles. This is so much fun.
She's slipping already.
Look, I was out of line for coming down on you, you know. This is none of my business, and she has every right to loan you money if she wants to.
How much did she pay you to say that?
There's nothing left. You cleaned her out.
Yeah, here we go again.
Oh, Jeff, come on. Seriously, Mom says you've really done your homework on this one, and it's a real solid idea.
You think so? God, I hope so. I just can't take another failure like Jiffy Pup.
It was Otto, Pat. You were just ahead of your time.
Thanks.
If Mom believes in you, so do I.
I appreciate that.
Yeah. Well, I'm just telling the truth, like the famous American said we should.
What famous American?
Come on, Samuel Foghorn Leghorn.
He was one smart chicken.
No. I'm talking about Mark Twain, the guy that wrote Huckleberry Hound.
When you were a kid, did Mom drop you on your head?
Yeah. The same day she dunked your head in that vat in there.
Hey, you got new reading glasses.
Yeah. After checking out 300 frames, I finally found the perfect pair.
And they're very cool. Extremely slimming.
For what they cost me, I could have hired somebody to read for me. Hi, Lucille. Sorry I'm late. Oh, that's okay. I'm having some trouble with this recipe here. What does this mean when they say coddle an egg? Oh, hello, egg. Look at your cute little yolk. Gianni Ferenzi glasses.
Oh, I didn't know what they were called. They were giving them away at the car wash.